we combined all the battery charging voltage settings of the Pulsar Smart 10K or Pulsar Smart 10KP all-in-one solar inverters and arranged their voltage values on a single horizontal voltage axis from low to high, we can analyze the typical sequence based on the full discharge to charge cycle of the battery. The exact voltage values should be set according to the specifications of the connected battery. To avoid misleading users, no specific values will be provided here. Starting at the far left is setting 15, battery cutoff voltage. This is the lowest point of battery discharge. When the battery voltage drops to this value, the inverter will immediately stop output to prevent further discharging. This value should be set slightly higher than the battery's minimum discharge limit to provide early protection. Next to the right is setting 12, battery low voltage. This helps prevent over-discharge when the battery voltage drops to this level. The inverter will stop output after a delay, which can be configured using setting 13. This value should be higher than the cutoff voltage to avoid immediate shutdown, but still limit further discharge. If setting 1, which is used to set output source priority, is set to SBU or SOL mode, the next item is setting 4, switch to utility voltage. When the battery discharges to this threshold, the inverter will switch from battery power to grid power to avoid deep discharge. Moving further right is setting 14, low voltage alarm. When the battery voltage reaches this level, the inverter will issue a low voltage warning but will not shut down. This value should be set higher than the setting 12 to give the user time to respond. Further to the right is setting 37, battery recharge voltage. When the battery voltage remains relatively high, the inverter will continue to maintain the battery charge with a low current. Once the inverter drops to this level, the inverter will start a new charge cycle. Then comes setting 35, low voltage recovery voltage. This indicates that battery has recovered from a low voltage state. It is typically used to resume battery output after shutdown caused by low voltage, as triggered by setting 15 or 12. Once the battery voltage rises above this level, the inverter will resume battery output to the AC terminals. Settings 35 and 37 can be set to the same value, as there is no strict order between them. However, note that setting 37 is triggered when the battery voltage drops to this threshold, while setting 35 is triggered when the battery voltage rises to the threshold. Continuing right on the voltage axis is setting 11, flow charging voltage. After the battery completes the boost charging stage, the inverter enters the flow charging stage. Maintaining the battery at full charge with a small current at this lower voltage. For lithium batteries, flow charging is not needed, so this setting should match setting 9. Next is setting 5, switch to battery voltage, which works together with setting 4. It sets the voltage threshold for switching back from utility power to battery power. Again, applicable only in SBU or SOL mode. Once the battery voltage rises to this level, the inverter will switch back to battery power. This value can be set according to the user reference. If you want to ensure the battery has a high and safe voltage before discharging again, set higher value. Finally, at the far right is setting 9, boost charging voltage. During constant current charging, once the battery voltage reaches this level, the inverter enters the constant voltage charging stage, also known as the boost charging stage. This value should allow the battery manufacturer's recommended charging voltage. That concludes the logic sequence and arrangement of battery charging voltage settings for the Pulsar Smart 10K or Pulsar Smart 10KP all-in-one solar inverters. Thank you to the user who adjusted this insightful analysis. We hope this video has been helpful. See you in the next one.